Bob Green, I have produced a short documentary to educate you on a cause that has been overlooked by many, and to explain my reason for requesting money from you. With your help, I believe we can fight this cause and restore the land of Gielinor back to its original state, or at least the habitat of the unicorns. I thank you in advance for listening. The Unicorn, a legendary animal from European folklore that resembles a horse with a large, pointed, spiraling horn projecting from its forehead. First mentioned by the ancient Greeks, it became the most important imaginary animal of the Middle Ages and Renaissance when it was commonly described as an extremely wild woodland creature, a symbol of purity and grace which could only be captured by a virgin. In the encyclopedias, its horn was said to have the power to render poisoned water potable and heal sickness. Until the 19th century, belief in unicorns was widespread among historians, alchemists, writers, poets, naturalists, physicians, and theologians. Unicorns are not found in Greek mythology, but rather in accounts of natural history, for Greek writers of natural history were convinced of the reality of the unicorn. No one believed them. No one thought that such a majestic and important creature in nature could be a reality. The legendary animal was only found in literature outside of the Greek natural history as an allegory which stood for incarnation. As soon as the unicorn sees her, the maiden as represented by the Virgin Mary, it lays its head on her lap and falls asleep. This became a basic, emblematic tag that underlies medieval notions of the unicorn, justifying its appearance in every form of religious art. Interpretations of the unicorn myth focus on medieval lore and beguiled lovers, whereas some religious writers interpret the unicorn and its death as the passion of the Christ. The myths refer to a beast with one horn that can only be tamed by a virgin. Subsequently, some writers translated this into an allegory for Christ's relationship with the Virgin Mary. While many other interpretations of the unicorn were widespread, it was still a legend in the minds of many. This anomaly made its way into Greek and Chinese mythology and was featured in the Bible, yet not a trace of it was left behind. Why? Let's take a look at the world of Gielinor. The world of Gielinor was molded by Guthix in the First Age when he found an empty plain and shaped it into what is now the land of RuneScape. An ancient plain filled with nature and folklore and lots of stuff? Like animals and such? Anyway, let's look at this once marvelous world and what it has become. This is a unicorn of Gielinor, as described earlier, majestic, legendary, adjective. This is what the life of a unicorn once was, peaceful and full of life. Look at it. Seriously, just look at it. See it? You see the unicorn, right? Well, then this happened. The inhabitants of Gielinor built the Grand Exchange over the unicorn's land. Is that fair? Well, probably. I mean, the unicorn wasn't really using the land to its full potential anyway. But still, is it right to take land from those who have earned it? From those who have found the land and inhabited it? Finders keepers? Of course it's not right, but we do it anyway. Because we're dicks and we have weapons and money. What's a unicorn gonna do? Poke us to death with its horn? Seriously, a horn? Have you seen my delicious clam tits? Anyway, back to the point. We drove these poor creatures out of their habitat because we needed it, and because they don't even drop anything of value. But seriously, now you must be thinking, what happened to these poor creatures? Do you even lift, bruh? Why does EOP insist on making a fool of itself every weekend? Well, this is what happened to the unicorn, you poor cunt. Due to a graphical the creation of the Grand Exchange, the unicorns were forced to suffer in the wilderness, a cold, dead land filled with volcanic ash and quicksand. The volcanic ash has led to the discoloration of the unicorn's beautiful ivory coat and hate crimes. The quicksand has also played a role in cutting the population of unicorns almost entirely in half. These poor creatures struggle to get themselves out, only to get themselves pulled in further. Should a man be incarcerated for its stupidity? Do people even care about unicorns in the first place? We may never know. Because seriously, the Grand Exchange is fucking sweet. Cash rules everything around me. Cream, get the money. Dollar dollar bill, y'all. Cash rules everything around me. Cream, get the money.
top side, the New York Times side. Staying alive was no job at second hands. Moms bounced on old man. So then we moved to Shaolin land. A young youth, you're rocking the gold tooth. Low goose, only way I begin to G-York was drug loot. And let's start it like this, son. Rolling with this one and that one. Pulling out gats for fun. But it was just a dream for the team who was a fiend. Started smoking wools at 16.